मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू योर ऑनलाइन बायोलॉजी क्लासेस। स्टूडेंट, एज यू नो, योर हाफ ईयर एग्जामिनेशन ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड एंड आई होप यू आर ऑल वेल एंड फॉलो द रूल्स, मीन्स द सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग एंड वेयरिंग मास्क एंड सैनिटाइज योर हैंड्स। ओके, आई होप यू आर ऑल वेल एंड आई होप यू आर ऑल कंप्लीटेड योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जामिनेशन वेरी वेल। एंड नाउ आई विल explain your next topic, next chapter, means health and diseases. You know, there are some topics are reduced in your 2020 and 21 syllabus in subject biology. In the second part of the biology, only one chapter, health and diseases, is remain. And today I will discuss your new chapter, why do we fall ill? Why do we fall ill? So open your chapter, why do we fall ill? Chapter number 5th, I think, in your NCERT book. Okay? So all of you open your book, chapter number 5th, why do we fall ill? Class 9th, subject science, biology. Today's topic is why do we fall ill? Okay, student, in this chapter we will learn about the health and its failure. What is health and what is the failure of the health? What is the causes of the health? And what is the infectious and non-infectious diseases? Infectious and non-infectious diseases. Their cause and manifestation. Their cause and manifestation. And also, diseases caused by, what is the reason? Diseases caused by different types of the pathogens like the virus, bacteria and protozoans. They are the pathogens which cause the various diseases in our body by virus, bacteria and protozoans. And also we learn what are the prevention. What are the prevention from getting diseases? And what is the principle of treatment of their prevention? What are the treatment of their prevention? And what is the pulse polio program? What is the pulse polio program? And TB, tuberculosis. Okay? So, student, food is our need because food provides us energy to life and growth and development to our body. Okay? And you know, our body is made up of the different kind of the cells and tissues. With different kinds of cells and tissues. When any part of the cells and tissue get infected or injured, we fall down. We fall sick. We fall sick. So, what is the definition of the healthy person? So, healthy person, a person who has socially and mentally, physically well-being. Okay? So, a healthy person, who is healthy person? A healthy person, if one shows, what shows? Means absence of any infection. Means is not suffering from any infections, small or acute, or chronic. Okay? And absence of any deformity, deformity means any defection in our body, no defection in our body. Third, absence of any heredity, hereditary defect, hereditary. So, what is a hereditary defect? This comes from one generation to the another generation. This is passes from the parents to their offspring. Okay, like hemophilia, sugar, and fourth means absence of diet insufficiency. Imbalance means they are not suffering from any dietary, means any food stuffs like protein, fat, carbohydrate, water, minerals, vitamins in their diet. And complete physical fitness. They show complete physical fitness, absence of mental problem, okay, freedom from anxiety. Means freedom from anxiety, freedom from psychological tension, freedom from psycho psychological
freedom, problem, problem, and also congenital surrounding. S U double R O U N D I N G, congenital surrounding, and P U R P O S E, purposeful living. So a all healthy person is that person who show this characteristics, means they have no infection in their body, no deformity in their body, no any hereditary defect in their body, and absence of diet insufficiency, imbalance, and complete physical fitness, okay, complete, and absence of mental problem, freedom from anxiety, freedom from psychological problems. Congenital surrounding means their surrounding very neat and clean. This also affect to their health, and imbalance and purposeful living. Without purpose, there is no living lifestyle. So always make your aim. Okay. So WHO, WHO World Health Organization. 1978 provided a definition for the health. I am going to draw this. You can also make some points. A healthy person who is, they show the different features. WHO, World Health Organization, 1978, they give a definition, and define health to be a state of complete physical, mental and social, physical, mental and SOCI, social well being, well being and not, okay, and well being. Write down the definition. So a healthy person is who that is so a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being properties. Okay, this teaches is so that that particular person is completely healthy person, completely healthy person. Now, personal and community means samudaya. A personal means vyaktigat. Both affect the health. Both affect the
हर मैटर ऑफ हेल्थ।
And what is the distance difference between the healthy and disease free? Healthy and disease free.
DIFF difference between healthy and DISE disease free.
Means healthy person, that person who show the following features, and disease free is the other part of the topic of this chapter. So you can write down some points. I am going to explain this. Okay, write down. It is the state of complete physical healthy person DISE disease free person. It is the state. It is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being. Okay, well-being, and it is the state of absence of. It is the absence of ABSEN, absence of deformed DEFORM. DE disformed DIS COM in any part of the body. It is the absence of discomfort in any part of body. Second, write down. It depends upon the individual as well as it depends upon individual as well as physical and social ENVIROMENT. Write down, student.
I am filling some ink in my pen.
students, disease free person, it is depend upon individual only. It is related to the, it is related to INDIVI visual only. Write down. Third means heavy person. A healthy person will be a healthy person will be disease free as well. And third, a disease-free person can be healthy or unhealthy. A disease-free person can be healthy or unhealthy. Means disease free is not ensure that is he will healthy person or unhealthy person. This is not ensure. But healthy person will be a disease free person. Okay? Now write down the fourth. The person will be energetic, the person is energetic and able to perform as per requirement and depend upon the person and personal attitude. So complete this 4 point in your rough copy. Sometimes a question asked in your examination, what is the disease free person and what is the healthy person? Both are the same, but there are some differences, internal differences. So there are 4 points which are I am
already discussed in on your board. Okay, so write down all of you. Disease and its causes. What is disease and its causes?
Write down, first of all, write down.
When student, when we understood or asked that the particular person is going to suffering from any diseases, so suppose our body is made up of the different types of cells and tissues, and they perform the different type of activity in our body. Suppose digestive tract perform the digestion in your body and provide energy. Kidney is responsible for the filtration. Heart for pumping the blood all over the body and receive the deoxygenated blood from all parts of the body. So how can we say that the particular person is going to show the symptoms and sign of the particular diseases? So only two things by which we can identify that the person is getting suffering from the particular diseases. So a well-known person or doctor or experienced person can identify that the particular person is suffering from the diseases. So there are two words, symptoms and sign. Are two things by which we can identify that the person is suffering from any diseases. Diseases and its causes.
DISEA, diseases and its causes.
We can identify by the two things, symptoms, symptoms and signs, signs. जब हम किसी व्यक्ति को देखते हैं तो उसके लक्षण, उसके सिम्टम्स को ऊपर, उसके सिम्टम्स और साइंस, SIGN साइंस को देखकर ही हम आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं कि वो व्यक्ति किसी रोग से पीड़ित है. सो वन वर्ड दिस इज मैनिफेस्टेशन. मैनिफेस्टेशन दिस इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एविडेंस, प्रमाण. कोई प्रमाण होगा तभी हम कह सकते हैं कि वो व्यक्ति इससे पीड़ित. सपोज दे आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम लूज मोशन, सो वी कैन कॉल दैट दिस दे आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम डायरिया, डिसेंट्री और कॉलरा. ओके, सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फिजिकल सर्च, मेंटल सर्च, we can say that the particular persons are suffering from the any symptoms and signs of the diseases. They indicate the person's presence of disease. They indicate
Kill the PRA presence of DISEAS. They indicate the presence of disease. And this they provide information. They provide information about the presence of particular disease. Particular DISEASE. Second, symptoms are collective manifestation. Diseases of particular parts of particular parts of organ, parts of organs. Second, they are distinct for different diseases. They are distinct for DISEASES. They are distinct for different diseases. Write down. Okay. Your time is going to over. Write down homework. Read. Difference between first healthy and disease free. Second, SYMP symptoms and SIGNS. Student, write down in your diary. And I hope you all read very carefully from your book, NCERT book, or you can read from any side book also. Okay? Thank you.